Hey, beautiful friends, it's me, Stormy, and it's time for your weekly horoscope for the week of January 13th. And before we jump in, Astrology 101 and 102 classes with me start up in February, so registration and enrollment are open. Click in the description box down below to get signed up, and I will see you for 12 weeks of delicious learning of astrology. If this is new to you, if you are looking to advance your understanding of how to use these aspects, read these charts, understand what the heck is going on when we pull up a horoscope, this is the class for you. And I look forward to seeing you there, okay? All right, this week, after last week, we had quite the event, right? It was an eventful, energetic, cataclysmic kind of week. And this week, right as we're coming in on Monday the 13th, the sun is going to come on over and jump on board where this Saturn and Pluto conjunction just happened. And remember, the sun is light, heat, life, and vitality. There's motivation, there's movement here. So yes, this may have been stressful. The energy may have even been heavy. There's a weight to it. It's Capricorn energy, so there is a seriousness to it as we're coming out of last week. But the sun makes you motivated, right? Where the sun goes, where he's interacting, we're like, okay, I can do this. Okay, us, we're gonna do this, right? So this is a very motivating kind of energy, and it will certainly be shining light, lots of light, some of the biggest light we've got on what that conjunction was showing you, in part with how you can use that lunar eclipse to move these activities forward. So we get right in here at the beginning of the week, okay? Now, the same day, but later in the day, Venus is gonna leave this energy of Aquarius, which I have told you before in the weeklies. I love Venus in Aquarius, especially around big, busy holidays, because Venus wants to just have all the feels, all the good, all the everything. She wants to just get in there with everything. And Aquarian energy is not like it. It's more head-centered, more intellectual. So it can be a little bit more detached. And at the holidays, in front of all of these eclipses and a conjunction, you don't have time to be taking on everybody's energy. I certainly don't. You know, that empathetic kind of feeling where they're just like kind of, it's too much. So having this casual Venus energy is very, very good in Aquarius. Also, it brings a lot of love, and it brings a lot of thinking financially to some of our intellectual pursuits. So hopefully you did good things and enjoyed that energy, because Venus is going to move on into the energy of Pisces. Now, for the next 4 weeks with Venus and Pisces, our love language maybe changes a little bit, right? We're a little bit more willing to be compassionate. We want to sing. We want to hear that best song ever. Oh, I used to watch this movie, French Kiss, with Meg Ryan over and over and over again. And every time Venus is in Pisces, I think about that movie. There's this line in it, you guys. Keep in mind, I was 19, okay? And she's in this telephone booth in Paris, and she says, I'm gonna get him back, Mom, and I'm gonna make him love me. And that was the time of Stormy's first love with my first husband. So it just gives me all of the feels, and also makes me giggle compassionately at the same time for the 19-year-old version of Stormy. So whatever that is for you, Venus may be bringing up the feels in the energy of Pisces. It's a wonderfully vulnerable and creative energy. So share yourselves this week if you can, depending on where it hits in your chart. You may also find that you need some downtime to love on you, and if that's what you need to do over this next couple weeks, please make sure that you do that and you take care of yourself. But I do love the level of compassion, forgiveness, and oneness that does come with this particular placement of Venus, okay? On Wednesday, January 15th, this is Let's Do Stuff Day. It's practical, it's earth-centered, it's endurance-centered, it's steady, it's practical, because we've got the sun and the moon coming together in just delicious alignment, a delicious harmony, a delicious balance with each other, and they're in earth energies. So if you need to get things done, if you've been feeling a little bit sluggish, you can throw your shoulders back, dust some dust off, and get a couple things done. Now, I don't know about you, when I get a really good energetic day, I try to use that bad boy like it owes me money, right? Like I am on the hustle, because I don't know when I'm always going to need to slow down and take a deep breath, right? Because what I used to do is work and work and work and work, and then try and plan like a two-day vacation as if that's what I needed. And during the vacation is when I would want to get all the stuff done. So instead, this is a time to remember, we've had this conjunction. Where do you have to look at where you're using your resources to be able to achieve and maybe adjust the way that you're doing things? So this is a wonderful energy to get things done quite practically, by the way. On Thursday, January 16th, as we're getting closer to the end of the week, Mercury is going to actually move now into the energy of Aquarius. So Venus and Mercury have switched directions, switched places this particular week. Mercury is a planet of the mind, very intellectual, likes the details, all of the pieces, communication, decision making, which is quite okay because Mercury in the energy of Aquarius, who's also very intellectual, it's an air sign, right? They like to go with the flow of different ideas, but this can create a place where your thinking is on go, right? Aquarian energy is very, very electric. There's a lot of thoughts, there's ideas, there's what about this and how does this happen? It's such a delicious space to be in, but sometimes it can be uncomfortable when Mercury's there because you're just on like hyper thinking, right? So one of the things I do want to tell you over the next 3 weeks is because your mind can be so busy and you can have so many ideas, jot things down, get it out of your mind and onto paper. And the universe is watching and listening and responding to new ideas that we have. Put them down on paper. Trust your intuition as well. Aquarius is not just this intellectual sign. They are so highly genius and intuitive as well. There is definite intuition to their innovation. So maybe just let it pour out, record yourself, speak with new people, share what's happening up here so that you can give yourself a little bit of calm to the mind, but also enjoy being so highly stimulated and the conversation that's happening because the universe lies in there. Your little nuggets of truth are available to you this week. It's just happening really fast, like at the speed of sound, right? Like it's just, you're just going this week. So keep in mind that you could also be very open-minded to many different kind of ideas. Aquarius is not going to just drop you a regular old idea. Now that said, if you are usually the person who has ideas that are really outside of the box, Mercury in Aquarius may drop you something so entirely practical that you're stunned that, you know, the answer is just do A, B, and C. You're like, but that's, I don't understand. It's so inside of the box that it's different and bizarre for me. So look at where the different brilliant intuitive ideas may be coming to you at the end of the week because you are responding to everything that still happened last week in a way that's getting ready to move you forward. So I think it's going to be a great week with all of the thinking that's coming over the next 3 weeks. I know I will have to watch how quickly I speak in my videos. You guys tell me about it every time we get into this placement, so I will be being mindful about it. But let me know what's happening in your hyper thinking times as well or your hyper communication times this week as well. All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I'll see you in Astrology 101 and 102, and I'll see you right back here next week as well. I love you. Bye.